Howdy, I'm Derek, and today I want to show you the easiest way to add your favorite custom Lambda functions in Excel to any workbook. If you don't yet know what Lambda is, it gives you a way to define your own custom functions without the need to write them with VBA. They simplify complex formulas, they extend what Excel can do, and they make it easy to manage your formulas from one central place. Once you try them, I gotta warn you, it's a little bit addicting. To learn more about Lambda functions, check out the article with the link in the comments below. If you use Excel a lot, I highly recommend building a library of your reusable Lambda functions so that it's easy to have them all in one place, you can share with colleagues, and you don't have to search through all your files every time you want to use one. That's exactly where this tool was born, leveraging a library to add Lambda functions super quickly to any workbook. It's a part of the Excelevate Excel add-in, which has hundreds of tools that help you do more in Excel in less time. All right, so let's check it out. There are three aspects to this. First, we're going to automatically save new Lambdas. We're going to quickly find them with an autocomplete search box. And third, we're going to manage them in bulk. All right, in this example file, we're going to add a new Lambda called L underscore age. I like to use L underscore just to indicate that it's a Lambda, and often that'll help you find something if you get what you name it. Okay, now we're going to do this by going to the Formulas ribbon tab under Name Manager. Notice there's nothing here yet. We're going to add this. Okay, so we're going to give it a name of L age. We're going to give it a comment. Calculates age, and then we're going to say that it refers to this formula here. Notice it starts with Lambda. That's how these work. Okay. Now that one is available in this file. Now optionally, you can have that automatically be added to your Lambda library if you want. You can toggle that on and off, and I find that's really helpful. Okay. Now we're going to open a new worksheet. Okay. Nothing in this one yet. Okay, just so you know, there it is. We're going to use the search box here, which I have tied and configured to a keyboard shortcut. You can set that if you want. This is a Lambda search box. Okay, so if we look for the word age, we can quickly find that new one that we just added. Notice there is the date that we added it. Okay, and all we have to do is press enter, and it automatically will add it to this workbook. Okay, we'll come back to the search box in here in just a minute. Just so you know how this works, let's say that we're adding a date here. We want to check out whether that works. Notice L underscore age is automatically going to show when we type formulas. There we go. 35 years old. Look, sounds right to me. Okay. Now, a couple more things about the search box. Okay. Notice that as you type, it's going to show you a whole bunch of results. So if you wanted to see, say, this one here, beginning of month, I like to use that one quite a bit. Let's see a little bit about this. Notice you can toggle that automatic save on and off. We can add Lambdas from the same group. Show you how that works in just a moment. Notice this one is in the dates group. There's the entire formula display. There's those comments. That's why that's so helpful. And we can also manage all of the Lambdas in our library by removing one record like this one, all of them, or even managing them in bulk. We'll look at that in just a moment, okay? Now, let's look at one that has a word valid in it. I've got a lot of validation. Okay, let's say we want to do this one. Now notice that that is checked, so it says all, add all in the group. So when we press enter on this one, it doesn't just add the one, it adds all the other ones in the group. Great way to add a whole bunch in one go. Now, if we wanted to use the third part, so the first part was automatically adding to the library, the second part was using that search box, the third part is managing them in bulk. And you can do that in a couple of ways. One is just by clicking the button in the search box. And what it's going to do is add your entire Lambda library to a new worksheet in your active workbook. Okay. Now, if you already have this worksheet in there, it will process it and it will make any updates to your library in the background. So you can update the date it was added, the name, the formula comment, the group that it's a part of, which is optional. And then you can also just put add with any of them that you want to add to your active workbook. So if you want to put them all in the same group, or if you want to add them all, just put add here. And as soon as you run this again, it will process any changes and it'll add any of them into that workbook that you want. Okay. So a lot of ways that you can manage your Lambda library in bulk, right? Now, using these tools, you can easily reuse all that effort from building great Lambda functions. If you haven't done much with them yet, you can also download a template that I've made that's got over 50 great examples that you can leverage. See the link in the comments below. You want to try any of these tools out related to managing your library of Lambdas as easy as you possibly can. Just go to www.excelevate.co under the app section or use the link in the comments below. If you enjoyed this, please like, please comment, share, tag with friends, subscribe so you don't miss other tools, tips, and tricks just like this one. Thanks for watching. Have an excellent rest of your day.